First of all, thanks for being here in my YouTube channel. So in this lesson number 6 on the topic coded inequality, we are going to learn a small concept called not greater than or equal to, not less than or equal to. Starting from lesson number 1, we have learned the basics, then medium level question. Then lesson number 3, lesson number 4, we have solved some of the tough level question in coded inequality. And lesson number 5, we have solved a complementary pair. But in lesson number 6, it is easiest to concept, but the beginners have some doubt regarding this greater than, not greater than equal to, not less than equal to. Why? Because while comparing, if the statement seems like this, in some cases you can see not less than equal to, not greater than or equal to. So in this cases where beginners feel little bit confusion that how to solve this. Listen here friends, it is so easy, you don't want to confuse anything. Let we learn the basics first of all. So after learning the basics, we can solve some of the question like this. Let me move on to the basics now. Listen carefully, if it is a coded inequality topic, again and again I'm repeating this, if it is coded inequality, there are three major symbols. What are all the symbols? One is greater than, next is less than, and the third is equal to. So these are the major symbol in the topic coded inequality. And listen carefully, for an example I have taken this. A not greater than or equal to B less than C. The meaning is not greater than or equal to. We can say this as neither greater, listen carefully, neither greater nor equal. So got it, both are same, right? Not greater than equal to, which means it is neither greater, not greater, and also not equal. Listen carefully, while comparing A and B, they are saying it is not greater. We can eliminate this greater than symbol. And it is also not equal. We can eliminate equal to symbol. What is the only symbol remaining, which is less than? So we can write this statement as A less than B less than C. That's it. You don't want to confuse anything by seeing this greater than or equal to symbol. So better you can write like this, A less than B less than C. Got it friends? If it is not greater than or equal to, then you need to say it is less than. Similarly, if in case they have given like this, A less than, not less than or equal to B. So what is the comparison between A and B? Listen carefully. The meaning of not less than or equal to is neither less than nor equal to. We know that the major three symbol, one is greater than, second is less than, and the third is equal to. And we know that while comparing A and B, it is neither less than. So eliminate less than symbol and also eliminate equal to symbol. What is the only symbol remaining, which is greater than? So finally, this statement can be written as A greater than B. That's it. You don't want to some students, what they are saying is they are writing more possible steps by seeing this. Kindly don't do that. It's a simple concept, right? If it is not greater than or equal to, then assume this as less than. If it is not less than or equal to, assume this as greater than. So this is the concept only you need to learn, right? So if you know this concept, then solving all the question that is based on this lesson number 6 is so simple. So for example, we can solve 3 different questions so that you will also get an idea how to solve the question that is not greater than or equal to or not less than or equal to. Question number 1. So here they have given a statement as C equal to G less than B less than or equal to L, not less than or equal to P equal to Q. And they have given a conclusion that conclusion number 1, Q less than B, conclusion number 2, Q less than L. So we need to check whether Q less than B is true or false. Similarly, Q less than L is true or false. So before comparing that, just change the given statement into a proper format. Listen carefully, L not less than or equal to Q. Just now I have told you, what is the meaning of not less than or equal to? We have three major symbols. One is greater than, next is less than, and the third is equal to. And they are saying that while comparing L and P, it is neither less than nor equal to. That is, while comparing L and P, it is not less than and also it is not equal to. So only one symbol that we have, that is greater than. So finally, L greater than P. Got it? So let me write the statement into a proper format. C and G both are equal. So we can write this as CG. Less than B, less than or equal to L. So L not less than or equal to P, which means L greater than P. So L greater than P, and P and Q both are equal. So we can write this as PQ. So finally, we have converted the given statement into a proper format. Now check whether the conclusion is true or false. Q less than B. They are saying that Q less than B. So while comparing Q and B, we have two symbol and one less than, one greater than. So definitely relationship cannot be established. So we can say that conclusion number one is false. Conclusion number two, Q less than L. So while comparing Q and L, we have only one symbol, that is L greater than Q or Q less than L, both are same. Similarly, conclusion 2 says Q less than L. So we can say that conclusion number 2 is true. So finally, answer for question number 1 is conclusion 2 alone is true. So simple, right? You don't want to confuse anything. Just convert this not less than or equal to greater than. If it is not greater than or equal to, convert this as less than. And you can proceed in a normal way. Question number 2. D equal to E, not less than or equal to J, greater than or equal to N, not greater than or equal to O, greater than or equal to S, not greater than or equal to T. So first of all, let me do one thing. We can remove all this not equal to and we can convert this given statement into a proper format. So first is D and E both are equal. So this can be written as DE. Next is not less than equal to. So the remaining symbol is greater than J. So greater than or equal to N. Here, not greater, not equal. So only symbol remaining, that is lesser. So lesser than O, greater than or equal to S. Here, not greater, not equal. So the remaining symbol is less than. So finally, we have converted the given statement into a proper format. Now, conclusion number one. Our target to check whether N less than or equal to D is true or false. So listen here, compare N and D. So while comparing N and D, we have two symbol, one is greater than and second is greater than or equal to. So while comparing both the symbol, the common out of both the symbol is greater than. So we can say that D greater than N or N less than D is true. But the conclusion says L less than or equal to D. So we can say that conclusion number one is false. Conclusion number two, N less than T. Our target to compare N and T. So while comparing N and T, we have one less than, one greater than. So definitely relationship cannot be established. So finally, for question number two, we got both the conclusion is false. Last third question. So Y not less than or equal to Z, greater than or equal to B, equal to C, greater than or equal to L, not less than or equal to M. So first step is you need to convert the given statement into the proper format. So first of all, Y not less than or equal to. So it is not less than and also not equal to. So the remaining symbol is greater than. So greater than Z, greater than or equal to B, and B and C both are equal. So we can write this as BC and greater than or equal to L. And not less than, not equal to. So the remaining symbol is greater than. So finally, we have converted the given statement into a proper format. So conclusion number one, M less than Y. So our target to find M less than Y, listen here. So M and Y. So while comparing M and Y, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 symbol. And the common out of all the 4 symbol is greater than is common. Here greater than, greater than, greater than, greater than. So while comparing Y and M, we can say that greater than symbol is common. So Y greater than M or M less than Y, both are same. Look at conclusion number 1, M less than Y. So we can say that conclusion number 1 is true. Conclusion number 2, L less than or equal to Z. L less than or equal to Z. Our target to compare L and Z. So while comparing L and Z, we have two symbol. One is greater than or equal to, greater than or equal to. So the common is greater than is also common, equal to is also common. So while comparing Z and L, we got an answer Z greater than or equal to L or L less than or equal to Z. Look at conclusion number 2, L less than or equal to Z. So conclusion number 2 is also true. So finally, for question number 3, we got an answer, both the conclusion is true. So friends, it's a easy lesson, but you need to learn this concept. So friends, finally, we have solved 3 different questions. In all the 3 different questions, we have targeted a small concept called not greater than or equal to, not less than or equal to. So only thing what you need to do is, you need to convert the given statement into the proper format. If it is not greater than or equal to, write this as less than. If it is not less than or equal to, write this as greater than. Then all the remaining procedure is same that we discussed in the earlier lesson. So friends, thank you so much for watching this video, and if you really like it, share this video to your friends, those who are preparing for competitive exams. Thank you so much. Bye.